All right, so let's go ahead and move into Eclipse. And what we're going to do is this project will work similar to the previous one. We're actually going to start with our student.form.html. We'll use that as a starting point, and then we'll just add new features in here for the checkbox. So the first thing I'm going to do with student.form.html is I'll do a right click and I'll choose copy. And then I'll do a right click and I'll choose paste. And now the new name here, we'll call this student checkbox form.html. So that's the new name for it. And then once you're happy with the name, you can click OK. Now let's go ahead and open up this student checkbox form.html. So the first thing we need to do here on line 7, we need to change the JSP that we're going to send the data to. So here I call it student checkbox response.jsp. That's the new JSP that we're going to create a little later in this video. Let me expand my window here. And also let me just get some extra white space down here so I can have some room to play, add another line break. And now I'll go through and start entering the information for my checkbox. So here I'll say input type equals checkbox. Name equals favorite language. Value equals Java. And then we put our label out to the side, Java. So again, very similar to radio buttons. The only thing that's different here is the input type equals checkbox. And now what I can do is I can simply repeat this process for all the other languages. So I'm just going to speed up the video here for a bit while I just do a copy paste and do a quick update for those other languages. All right, I'll just save my file. So, okay, this looks really good right now. So basically I have the four languages here, input type of checkbox, and that works out really well. So our HTML form for the checkboxes is pretty much taken care of for right now. Good job. All right, so let's do a similar thing here for our response page. So again, we're going to use that student response.jsp as a starting point, and then we're going to customize it. So I'll simply copy this file, and then I'll right click and I'll do a paste for it. And the new name that we'll give here, of course, is student checkbox response.jsp. And once you're happy with that name, go ahead and click OK. So now we have this new file here, student checkbox response.jsp. Now let's go ahead and double click this file and open it up. This is the original confirmation page from before. Let me just add some line breaks here. And I just expand the window so I can have more room to work with. And so what I need to do here is I need to display the list of favorite programming languages that the user selected. So it's going to be an HTML list of data. And I just want to get some more white space here at the bottom. Give me one second. All right, so I'll make use of an HTML tag UL for unordered list, and I will put in multiple list items here, but I'll actually generate these on the fly using a JSP scriptlet. So notice the angle bracket percent, and now I can write real Java code. So here, what I want to do is use that request I get parameter, and I want to get parameter values because it's going to be multiple items that are going to be returned, and then I'll say favorite language. Okay, good. Now I actually have a syntax error here because this method request get parameter values, it returns an array. So I need to add the square brackets here for an array on line 14. That took care of that error. So now I simply need to just do a for loop through that array and, display list items here. So I'll set up this for loop, string temp lang, that's my temporary variable, colon lang's the actual array itself. And then I simply do an out print line. I just do li for a list item. And then I just append the temp lang. And then I just close off the slash li. So this is basically we're generating HTML on the fly with our JSP, which is a good little example here of using JSP scriptlets. All right, so to recap here, We read in all the parameter values, and then we do the for loop, and we print out all the list items. All right, so this looks really good so far. All right, so I'll save my file. Now let's go ahead and run it. So let's run the form. So our student checkbox form.html, just do a right click, run as, run on server. Okay, great. So here's our form. We can enter our first name and last name. And then we can go through and choose the languages. So now we can choose multiple languages here. So I'll choose Java and C# just to start. I'll hit submit. And here it says student is confirmed. And hey, there's our list, Java, C#, which looks okay. But I noticed I didn't put my little description at the beginning of the favorite languages. So let me just do that real quick. So I'm back in my JSP right now. And I'll just say favorite programming languages, just text so you can see it on the actual HTML page. Do my little BR break there and save that. Now when I go back to my form, just click on back in the browser, then I can just choose maybe a different language here, Ruby, and hit submit. So now we have our little header or our little description there along with whatever language they selected. And also I can just play around with it. I can add multiple languages here, like maybe just PHP and Ruby, hit submit. And we see those displayed here in the browser. And then I could maybe just choose all of them and see if this works. And it does, right? So it's simply reading those values and doing a for loop and walking through all of those items. So this is really good. So we're, I'd say we're successful. So we had a HTML form with checkboxes and we read the data with JSP. Very good. Good job.